is the difference between object-oriented programming and domain-driven design? My name is Vikas Kerni. I have more than 20 years experience in IT industry. I am TOGAP certified architect. Do subscribe to my channel for your regular. Domain-driven design has become very popular in recent years. A lot of domain-driven design concepts like repository, unbounded context, and anti-corruption layer has become a common vocabulary in the world of cloud computing, microservices, development. I was forced to think, why domain-driven design has become so popular? We have object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming was about mapping the real-world objects into software. And domain-driven design talks the same thing. Why domain-driven design is so popular? So what is domain-driven design first? Domain-driven design is about coming up with one language, common vocabulary that business domain experts and the programmers can speak, understand, and use in daily life. This brings to me this question. Okay, domain-driven design is about building software according to the domain needs, having a common language. Is domain-driven design is object-oriented programming plus one common language? Do we need it? Another question came to my mind. Do we need domain-driven design if we are doing object-oriented programming properly? Now coming to my own experience of object-oriented programming. First, whether object programming can be used to map real objects into software, there is a difference of opinion among experts. Some experts don't agree, is this possible? They think software is demonstrating only a part of the real world. It's not the whole world. Paul Graham said, most of the companies are using object-oriented programming because they have very mediocre programmers. Object-oriented programming, discipline of object-oriented programming prevents programmers to do too much damage. And leave experts, lot of time when we start doing object-oriented programming, a lot of things we do are driven by our low-level programming needs. Our object-oriented model is a lot of time influenced by our prejudices, our previous experiences, our preferences, our databases, the vocabulary being used by the developers. So how many times when we build the object, as it matured, we went back and we saw whether our object model was corresponding to the business model. So over the time, our business model, you can say either evolved or corrupted. It became different from the business model. Now you came up a need for the mapping business model to the software model. Business model is different, software model is different. You need people, you need to document, you need to help translation layer, you need people to tell you, okay, this business concept, how is written into the software. So, and a lot of time we did not know where our object model started and finished. we ended up writing all user interface code, database driven code, lot of infrastructure driven code. Our model was not clean, as the clean architecture says that our domain model should not have any technology related information or any databases related information. It should have just the business domain logic, business logic. It should just have business logic. Joe Armstrong said nicely, the problem with objective-oriented programming is they have got all this implicit environment that they carry around with them. You wanted a banana, but you got a gorilla holding the banana and the entire jungle. I think what he means is our domain, our object model is not that clean over the time, because and it's intermingled with other concerns with infrastructure code. So that way, domain-driven design is a very good concept. It forces developers to conform to the business model, not to include their own prejudices, their own preferences, their decisions into the development of software system. Thanks for watching this video. My name is Vikas Kerni. I have more than 20 years experience in IT industry. Do subscribe to my channel for your regular updates.